the bobby pin?
That's a good way to lose a man. He takes you to the baseball game you send you to me. He says, "Oh, next man up at bat will punt, you'll see." Don't say, "Ooh, what's the bunt? This game's too hard for little me." Just say, "A bunt? What are you, nuts?" With one out, two men on base, and a left-handed batter coming up, he'll walk right into a triple play, just like it happened in the third game of the World Series in 2003.
That's a sure way to lose a man. A sure, 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 sure way to lose a man. A splendid way to lose a man. Just throw your knowledge in his face. He'll never try for second base.
98 ways to go. A third way to lose a man. A lifeguard at the beach that all the girlies adore. Swims bravely out to save you through the ocean's roar. Don't say, "Oh, thanks, I would have drowned in just 1 second more." No, just push his head under the water, scream, "Last one is arriving!" and race him back to shore.
That's the swell way to lose a man. You found your perfect mate, and it's been love from the start. He whispers, "You're the one to whom I give my heart." Don't say, "I love you too, my dear. Let's never, never part."
Just say, "Oh, I'm afraid you've made a grammatical error. It's not to who I give my heart, it is to whom I give my heart." You see, with the use of the preposition to, who becomes the indirect object, making use of whom imperative, which I can easily show you by drawing a simple chart.
That's a fine way to lose a man. A fine, 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 fine way to lose a man. A dandy way to lose a man. Trust me, you are well informed than he. You'll never hear a promise me. Just show him where his grammar errs. Then mark your term of hers and hers.
Yes, girls,
you too can lose your man if you don't know.